From living in quarantine for weeks to plans if they didn't make it back. Stay tuned to number one to find out 10 amazing facts about the moon landing. Number 10. Spectators were kept way back. When it came to NASA's moon missions, the technology of the time was still very experimental. After all, just to get to the moon was a task all of itself. Then, they had to get them back. Yeah, it wasn't a sure thing. So in many ways, they had to overcompensate for things that might cause issues. But in return, this overcompensation was a bit of a danger, both to the astronauts and to the people watching the launch in Florida. For the Apollo 11 mission, the rockets that were used to send the ship into space, known as the Saturn rockets, were so huge and full of fuel that if anything went wrong and they somehow exploded, they would be able to send shrapnel about 3 miles away from the explosion. And yes, depending on the explosive force and shockwave, this could very well happen. So, to ensure that no one was hurt outside of the immediate area, should that happen, all of the VIPs that were there to see this historic mission were actually kept 3.5 miles away from the launch site. In this case, it most definitely was better safe than sorry. Number 9. Custom forms. You would think that being astronauts would make you exempt from certain rules and laws and regulations before, during, and after the mission, but you would be so wrong. For some of the agencies take their rules and regulations very seriously. And it doesn't matter to them if you just came from the moon, you better have the right forms in hand when you make land. This is exactly what happened to the Apollo 11 astronauts after they returned home, and they were forced to complete customs forms. If you're curious as to why they had to do such a thing, it's quite simple. You see, they didn't just return home themselves, rather they brought moon rocks and moon dust for scientists back home to study. This would lead to a much greater understanding of the moon and its contents, which also led to the definitive discovery of why it glows at night, as its regolith, what it's comprised of, is highly reflective, and thus it absorbs the sun's light in part and bounces it off, making it shine. Going back to customs, the crew had to fill out forms for the moon rocks and moon dust. They literally had to label the route they took as Cape Kennedy, Florida, to the moon, and finally, to Honolulu, Hawaii. Laws, man, they'll get you every time. Number 8. We need a new flag. Before we talk about the flag that was left on the moon, take a moment to like this video and join the Zero to Hero community by clicking the buttons below. The Apollo mission had numerous iconic images, from the first steps on the moon to Neil Armstrong's famous line and more. But one of the most important moments of all was when the team planted the flag on the moon itself. For those who weren't around then, the United States and the Soviet Union were in the middle of the Cold War, and their desire to one-up each other was growing every single day. The space race, as it was called, was an important milestone for this rivalry, as the first to get to the moon and back safely would be seen as a true victor. So, when Buzz Aldrin and Neil Armstrong put the American flag on the surface of the moon, it was a big PR win back home. Here's the thing. The flag? It's gone. No, it wasn't removed in later missions. Actually, it didn't survive the first one. For according to Aldrin, when he and Armstrong left the moon, the module's thrusters actually blew the flag away. While it may not have been destroyed then, the surface of the moon and the conditions of space no doubt made it go away for good. Number 7. Life insurance. To say that the Apollo 11 mission was risky was an understatement. Granted, there had been many successful missions into space, including some that actually circled the moon, like Apollo 9. However, as the first Apollo mission showed, terrible things can happen, and the crew of the Apollo 11 knew that. Sadly, at the time, an astronaut wasn't a highly paid position. As such, they couldn't afford life insurance policies, so they had to figure out a way to support their families, which were naturally nervous about the situation as well, should the worst happen. So what did they do? Well, they decided to use their fame and possibility of death in a really clever way. You see, part of the preparation for the launch of the shuttle was to be in quarantine for a certain amount of time to ensure that sickness didn't befall the pilots. So they used that time to write autographs on any and all pieces of paper and NASA memorabilia that they had within their grasp. Should the mission have failed and they be unable to make it back home, the autographs would be sent off to their families, who could sell them and thus make a potentially decent living. Thankfully, that plan never needed to come to fruition, and the families were very well off after they landed. Number 6. No litter laws on the moon. There are many things that are unsaid about missions such as Apollo 11. For example, it took days to get to the moon, which meant that the men on board had to eat, drink, and go to the bathroom during that time. So for those paying attention, let me ask you, what did they do with all the waste? Granted, some of it could be expelled out into space itself, but not all of it. So the honest answer is, they just dumped it on the moon. No, really, they did. In fact, as Aldrin and Armstrong waited to go and disembark the lunar module, they gathered up all of their garbage, and when the door opened, Armstrong threw it out. If you look at the first picture of the moon, you can see the garbage right there. Lest you think they were being foolish and inconsiderate, there was a reason for this. You see, as mentioned before, they had to bring moon rocks and dust onto the ship to take back home. Space shuttles are constructed to be near perfect in terms of how much weight they can hold and still do their jobs. So to compensate for the moon rocks, the duo had to get rid of a lot of things, including tools and other materials that they wouldn't need for the return trip. Included in the things left behind is a plaque saying, "Here, men from the planet Earth first set foot upon the moon. July 1969 AD, we came in peace for all mankind." It's still there today, all of it. Well, except possibly that flag. Number 5. X doesn't mark the spot. You might look at the Apollo 11 mission and think it was a complete success, but it wasn't. You see, where they landed on the moon wasn't where they were supposed to land on the moon. This all happened when the lunar lander separated from the craft it was attached to in space. The cabin had a malfunction and it wasn't fully depressurized. This resulted in gas being let out in a sudden manner. This pop, as it's referred to, set the lunar lander off course. It was 4 miles away from where it was supposed to land. Thankfully, that didn't affect the mission as a whole, and they were able to land, take off, and make it back home safely. Number 4. Stick the landing. Another issue that the Apollo mission had upon arriving at the moon was that because of them being off course, they had to land in an area that they weren't really prepared for. Remember, they were 4 miles away from where they were supposed to be. That area was picked because it didn't have anything massive to hurt the module when it landed. But because of the new area they found themselves in, Neil Armstrong had to burn more fuel to get them away from a crater that they were now headed for. Using the fuel they had, Armstrong was able to get them away from the crater and land safely, but he cut it really close, as the landing consumed almost all of their fuel. There was only about a minute left. Without that fuel, they would not have been able to take off again. Number 3. Delivered, then sealed. Remember the customs form that the trio had to fill out? Well, there was one extra part of that that you should know about. Because since no one had ever been to the moon's surface before, there was no way of knowing what the astronauts could contract, if anything at all. They simply just didn't know. So once they were back on Earth and in Hawaii, and had delivered all of the contents of their mission, all three men were thrown back into quarantine again. But not for a few hours, or even a few days. They were in there for weeks. The NASA teams went over the moon rocks and the spacesuits as well as the astronauts themselves to ensure that nothing was brought back to the Earth that could infect other humans. After 3 weeks of quarantine, the astronauts were finally let go. Number 2. Three's a crowd. Pop quiz! Who were the three astronauts on the Apollo 11 mission? You should already know two of them. I've said their names enough on this list already. The answer is Neil Armstrong, Buzz Aldrin, and Michael Collins. Most people remember the first two names because they are most associated with the mission. But what about Collins? Well, you could argue that Collins had the most important job of all during the moon landing. He was keeping their ship in space. While Aldrin and Armstrong were getting all of the glory for the landing on the moon itself, Collins was up in the command ship making sure that everything was staying stable and ready for when the two would return to the ship. In fact, he had a heavy burden assigned to him because of this, for if the worst should come to pass, Collins would have been ordered to return to the Earth alone. When he was alone in the module, he noted that if they would have passed away, it would have stuck with him for the rest of his life. Number one, and now, a message from the president. You almost have to wonder how many backup plans NASA had to think about for this mission. What would have happened if the shuttle didn't fly? What would have happened if the lunar module didn't eject like it should have? And on and on. But one backup plan that they knew they had to have ready was if the astronauts didn't come back. Specifically, though, they wanted to make sure that they had something in case the astronauts got stuck on the moon. That's a grim thought, but for NASA, it was honestly the most likely ending given all the variables. They had no doubts, or very few, that the team would make it to the moon. It was everything else that they feared would go wrong, not being able to get back to the orbiter being the big one. So NASA contacted President Richard Nixon to have him deliver a speech should the worst come to pass and Aldrin and Armstrong didn't come back. This really happened, and the procedure would be that Nixon himself would contact the families of the astronauts and tell them the bad news, after which he would make a special announcement on the television. While the speech was obviously not read, we do know the beginning of it. Fate has ordained that the men who went to the moon to explore in peace will stay on the moon to rest in peace. What do you think about the amazing stories of the moon landing? Let us know in the comments below and take care.